By faith we see the hand of God. In the light of creation's grand design. In the lives of those who prove his faithfulness. Who walk by faith and not by sight.
Well, good morning. Thank you for being here. It's Thursday. What a joy it is to open God's Word together again. I'm just loving reading through the book of Luke. Maybe you are as well. This is Clint Davis, Chester RP Church Devotional Podcast. Thank you for joining us as we work our way through it. We've been in Luke chapter 2. We started it yesterday, the story of Jesus' birth. I'm going to pick this story up in verse 8. I could go back and have another couple podcasts on. They're only 5 minutes long is my time frame on the first 7 verses, but I'm just going to pick this up and continue to press forward. And this is the story of when the angels announced the birth of Jesus to the shepherds. And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. The angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is well pleased." When the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds had told them. But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them. And at the end of the 8th day, when he was circumcised, he was called Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The birth of a Savior. We talked about the humility of his humble origins, of his birth yesterday. Today, the humility of the shepherds who received the initial announcement. That's by design, by the way, guys. It's designed that God would announce the birth of the shepherd of God's people, the good shepherd, true shepherds. It's also designed that God would announce the birth of the Savior of sinners to the lowly people, the lowly shepherds who were cast out, pushed aside. It's important to note that God would say that he would announce the birth of the king to some of the poorest people. The reason he does that is because he wants to demonstrate the wonder and the majesty and the glory of his kingdom. And he wants to show to us, as we read it, just how wonderful this announcement is and this Savior is. He's the Savior of sinners. He's the lover of our souls. He is the humble king who will give himself as a sacrifice. He is the shepherd of his people, the good shepherd. He is the one who is the door. He is the one through whom we have hope. He is the one who cares for his people. And so this is all by design. The angels announce his birth and say it's great tidings to all with whom he is well pleased. God is pleased with those who have faith in him. It's great tidings to those of us who have faith in him. And for that, we are thankful. And then they go and they find him exactly as he is prophesied. He is in Bethlehem. He is in a manger. He is there with Mary and Joseph. In that city, in that manger, with those parents. All, again, by design, to point to the reality of the fact that God is fulfilling the promises he made to his people. There is no mistaking the identity of this Savior. I think sometimes we miss it because he was born in a lowly setting. Sometimes we're tempted to miss it because we think he was born 2,000 years ago and not in the present day. But the reality of it is in the perfect time, God sent forth his son, and there was no mistaking at that moment who this son was, who this Savior was. And so as you read this, as we think about this, think about the purposeful nature of God in having the Savior born in the way he was born, in the place where he was born, to the people to whom he was born, and announced in the way he was born, and announced to the people that he to whom it was announced that he was born. It's an amazing story of God's grace and love for how much he loves you and how much he loves me. And the angels go and tell it. They're excited. They want to go see this thing. I want you to come see him as well. I want you to see Jesus in the word of truth. I want you to see him in my life. I want you to go tell others as well. I want us to celebrate the birth of our Savior, the entrance of our Savior to the world. Hey, guys, have a great day. God bless you.